the main problem now is relation about how human and their ecologies or their environment, nature, etc., and that manifests more significant today, like through the climate crisis, pandemic, also industrialization. That kind of relation and also expansion is all, actually also we are feeling almost every day in Jatiwangi. We are in that kind of main problem. It's also related to how we kind of articulate our position now in Jatiwangi through our artistic practice or collectivity. It's not only about like working together or living together or collaboration, but how we can articulate our collective position in these main problems, or like especially the industrial expansion, the urban expansion that also really affected our environment. That, for example, like the microclimates, the living space now also become the main problem. How everyone's not only human but also all inhabitants struggling within living space. For me, it's interesting about how we evoking our subjectivity. I think it's important, and also thinking in the related again to our surrounding, accommodate in the how we imagining our own area, something kind of that, and become a subject in this kind of situation. That formation for us, it's important for us. That's also not only in Jatiwangi but also everywhere, because for example now our imagination is narrated by only one single imagination, like, and then how we can also everyone, I think, stimulating their own collective imagination is something that I think needed today.
Ini kali deh sebenarnya mah kita ruang komunikasinya memang kan ruang komunikasi top down. Semua media dikuasai oleh satu, yang tadi bilang Ismail, satu impian gitu. Nah, bagaimana kita membuka ruang-ruang komunikasi yang cukup leluasa hingga sekat apa pagar satu sama lain itu mulai runtuh gitu. Misalnya pagar ekonomi, pagar politik, pagar agama, pagar seni itu juga jadi terbuka gitu. Mungkin ruang komunikasi ini yang terus-terusan harus diingatkan bahwa kita sedang diarahkan oleh satu impian yang satu itu gitu. Tentang kemajuan, tentang apapun, cuma satu
kesejahteraan. For example in Jatiwangi, like how the soil or the land also giving us an agency to become subject in this situation. Like Jatiwangi long time become a roof tile base producer, like, so simply like soil become kind of commodity, right, through the roof tile, etc. But then also we have a lot of memory within roof tile, also relates cultural relation that actually can be also stimulating, or like can be also seeing as our own identity. So that's why we make a lot of activity through Rampak Genteng, our roof tile orchestra festival, bodybuilding ritual, and then now we see, we feel also the soil as our collective identity, and through this kind of collective, and we are imagining that also Jatiwangi actually should become an area that we still cultivate our soil in various dignity way or like area. We feel and we experiencing that actually artistic practice can stimulating collective imagination based on our experience, but then how we can also after that then continuing this collective imagination into more concrete strategic or like both in the policy level and also in the grassroots action, something like that. That's what we want to figure out, for example, with our collective forest project, the new rural agenda. I think also like we more talk about it because it's related directly to our how we will live, how we, the, our future will be. Yeah, maybe also already lose, like Arif always say, like we already lose since beginning actually, but then can we also lose in the cool way? Yeah, very, very good question actually. Called community development or bottom up or participatory, actually it's something that also very technical. But then if we come from this kind of collective imagination, actually that's something that I'd say like really accommodating the bottom up models. But how we can stimulate the collective imagination, I think artistic practice something that really can stimulate this kind of imagination. And organically we are dominated by one single narration, right? For example, if we do hearings to the with the public and asking what do you want for Jatiwangi, it's 80% will say they want factory or they want, because that's kind of imagination that dominate I think everywhere about the economical wellness, etc. So this kind of artistic practice should can reclaim this. I mean, I think that's the role of art. I think like reclaiming this kind of dominant imagination, making alternative way or hacking or etc. And maybe I don't know. Maybe that one can be also seeing as methodology and when in every different context. But then, yeah, of course, for example, in the rural European context, for example, yeah, maybe the tactic will be different, but then the premise maybe will be same. Because, for example, like in Jatiwangi, like our collective imagination can stimulate kind of organically, and also like, because also we already have our social capital relation, for example, like Ari family, kind of the very well known lot of relation before, and in our rural context also like police is also our neighborhoods, army also our neighborhood. So I think, and we are more prefer to not doing in confronting way because all is like neighborhood or families. I mean, sometimes we don't need something, also we should convince for several people, especially for example, for a language. That's why I think Jav also didn't have, always have many language. Like, for example, when we are talking with the local government, I think the form of exhibition in the white group sense is also sometimes more effective, because rather but then if we talk with our neighborhood, maybe another form, like creating festivity, togetherness, something that, so that's kind of many language. And I think one of point that also we are feeling is important is how we can also seeing what we are doing is something that we can also sharing the interest together. So not only about, for example, when we make a Rampa Genteng, like 11,000 people. How everyone can sharing their interest also in this event. And this is kind of something our event together. For example, the school seeing this Rampa Genteng as something that make them also have more students, or the police join in this guitar orchestra, because it's also time for them to making a good image. A moment that we are connecting together, and then we see another collective creature. 10 years ago, like 2010, I remember like Jav have Jatiwangi Artist in Resident Festival. Like we invite artists to resident to stay in Jatiwangi for 2 weeks, and then making something together with us and with our neighborhood, etc. And I remember at that time, 2010, there is 22 artists, and then can we distribute to stay in 7 villages. And I see like all the people from the village come out from their house. Whoa. Like we are kind of feeling excitement together, like feeling like collective moment, like But then after this kind of industrial come, it's very hard for us to also come to every village. Because first also now they have their own budget, and also now a lot of factory that's also arrive in their land. This kind of places or like activity may be important, I mean, especially in the rural area, to expand your horizon of imagination. Because, for example, now a lot of factory comes, and then also a school. I think if they see this is kind of opportunity, the only thing that they are think about is like after graduate from the school, they'll go to this factory. The imagination is very narrow. But then if we, for example, because I experienced this in Jav, I meet many people from various background, artists, designer, various culture, etc. Very diverse, diverse culture, not monoculture. Yeah, so I think and it expanded at least like my horizon of imagination to imagining what will I'm doing like for the next 10 years, and probably that's important, still important for our next generation, or for my daughter, for example, Arif's son. Especially in the art scene now, they are talking about collectivity, right? Like working together, etc. And like everything worthwhile if doing with other people. I think, that's kind of true. I think how we can also seeing this collectivity, not only in the romantic ways, because for example in Indonesia or in Jatiwangi, we are already by default like living together or like living in the collective. But then our collectivity also we will follow this dominant imagination narration, or can we also expand this collectivity to also creating our own collective imagination?
Siap genteng, siap genteng, wah suaranya genteng.